Hey everyone, I've got something a little bit different here today. This is a package that I bought from monofigs.com, and the nice sticker on the outside of the box suggests what's inside. However, I didn't get this set of 27 of these figures. I got a set of 21 of the figures. Monofigs from monofigs.com. These are genuine Lego minifigures made monochrome with no printing whatsoever on them. This is for a very small niche of folks who just like the looks of these. I saw a news article about them on BrickSet, where I get all my vast majority of my Lego news from, because they're awesome and they have a great database to go with it. And I said, you know what? I want those. One time purchase, why not? Now, what makes these special? I'm gonna tell you this first. This set that I got here of 21 different figures cost $225 US. $225 US. 21 figures. $225 US. Yeah. For these. So here's the thing. I'm not sure exactly how I'm going to organize these, but here's the thing. Some colors are pretty easy to make, like I'm assuming black, red, blue, probably, you know, white for sure. Very easy to make. You can get these pieces from Lego, just from regular sets and such. However, some of these, not so much. Like, for instance, I looked it up, and on this guy here, well, they recently brought in some lime green unprinted heads for Hero Factory. That's cool. But the torso, as I understand it, has never been made by Lego without a print. So what this guy does, who runs Monofigs, a leading authority on these things in the world, he actually removes the print. And these are still, like I said, they're genuine actual Lego pieces, all of them. But he goes through an undisclosed process, a multi-step process from what I'm seeing, because it doesn't look like it was just removed with chemicals. Maybe he found a good chemical, but looks like it's in really good shape. Just looking at the, there you can see the shine off it. So, you know, some of these are not brand new pieces. Some of the pieces were only made within certain years and then weren't made again. But the idea here is that if you want to be able to create a nice rainbow of figures, you can. And it's just for display. And yes, it is expensive. It's just how it is. I don't know any other way to do it, but it's really cool to be able to set these up. This is a set of 21. He also has a set of 27, like you saw on the outside of the package. And he has a set of, I think it's 36. The set of 36 costs over $500 US. Now we're talking absolutely ridiculous, right? Well, again, it has to do with the rarity of the parts. Some of the parts, especially on the higher end offerings, some of the parts just are very difficult to get, and then additionally require processing to, you know, take prints off and such. So, you know, if something was only ever made in one particular color in one set so far, and then has to have prints removed from that piece or a couple other pieces on the figure, it's a lot of manual labor. You can do it yourself. People do it, and that's fine. I personally didn't want to take the time to do it. I wanted to be able to set up a nice little rainbow effect like this, and yeah, I'm not stacking them all the best way. I'm kind of admiring this. This is my first time seeing them in person, kind of admiring them myself as I do this. But yeah, I didn't want to spend the time doing this. Not just, you know, going through and removing the prints, which is not as easy as it may sound, but also the time required to go through BrickLink and, you know, finding the individual pieces. So to be able to get just a collection like this, have somebody else do it for me is nice. It is definitely not for everybody. I just realized that you can't see all of them. So let me split this just a little bit more. It's not for everybody. It will definitely seem like too much, the price, for some folks, like a ridiculous price to spend on a small number of figures that don't even have faces. And that's cool. It should seem ridiculous to some folks. It's, like I say, it's a very small niche thing. And yeah, I just wanted to check them out, and I will figure out a place to display them or a way to use them. And if you're interested in checking out monofigs, you can. Also, check down in the comment section. I will put up a pinned comment. Hopefully that works on the device that you're using. YouTube can be weird about some of their features. Sometimes working, sometimes not, but I'll put up a pinned comment with a link to a free document put together by the same person who runs monofigs, just talking about some of the history behind some of the colors, the individual colors, you know, where you can find certain ones. I don't think it's completely up to date, but it's really, really well presented and has some interesting information, and gives, it's somewhat of a bit of, well, it's quite a bit of self-promotion in that, but it also gives you a good amount of context for the reason behind the price for all of this. These parts look to be in good shape, even though not all of them are new. The biggest exception, I'd say, is the pair of arms on this white one. Thankfully, they are very common, but you can see a difference in color. You will see differences in colors if you do end up buying some of these for yourself for a gift or something. You know, even within a specific Lego set brand new, you can see variations in color sometimes. And, you know, folks who have been dealing with Lego for a long time are very aware of that. Whites, oranges, lime greens, dark red made a major change along the way. But these right here are a little bit older, just a little bit yellowed, a little bit disappointed by that. Fortunately, I've got plenty of replacements, but I'll probably send a little email saying, hey, you got to get your whites right, man. Do those new since they're so readily available. There you go. Little package from Monofigs, and like I said, I'll have to see what I'm gonna do with these and how I'm gonna display them. I think they look awesome, and I wanna make good use of them for sure. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you again soon.